Welcome back, everyone. So today I'm going to read a very special book, which is very special for me. I will tell you why is it very special. Before that, let me introduce you the book which I'm going to read. The book which I'm going to read is Amamma Sari, written by Nivedita Subramanyam. So this again is one of the Neev Book Award shortlisted 2020 picture book. And this is one of the wordless picture book. Okay, now coming to why I like this book a lot. So when we think about sari, how many of us get a good feeling about it? I do. I love sari and I mostly end up reading most of the books which are surrounding the sari and about sari and all. And I love wearing it. So that's the reason I wore sari. Because I got inspired about this book, the story so much that I decided to wear it today. So now coming back to the story, what is the book about? What is the Amamma story about? So as you all know, most of the time the title gives a clue about what the story could be. This is about, this book is again giving us a clue about the whole story of the book. So Amamma Sari is the whole book is about Amamma Sari. And let's read, let's get into the reading to find out what is that about the Amamma Sari. Is there something to do with it? So let's find out. Are we all ready to get into the Sari, get into Amamma's story? Okay, by the way, Amamma is a word which is used in most of the Indian languages, mostly in the South Indian languages. It's called, it means the grandmother. Okay, so let's go and look into the reading. I want you all to look into the pictures very carefully and see how the texture is, you know, how each pages is laid out. How different is it from the other regular picture books? Title of the book, Amamma Sari, author Nivedita Subramanyam, publisher Tulika, year of publication 2019. Here you can see a tiny little girl who is curiously looking into a hole of a sari which is hung for drying. Now, the tiny girl peeps into the hole of the sari and Amamma is there as well, looking into the sari. Here, the girl is very curious to see what Amamma is doing. Amamma is into her snipping and stitching of the sari. And there is her pet which is playing behind her. Her grandfather is playing with her little baby brother on one side, and the other side, the girl is drawing paintings on the wall. And if you see, the sari has become a beautiful curtain. Uh-oh, what is the cat done here? It's played all over the curtain, and what, the curtain is become now. It has lots of holes and finally the curtains have been torn by its sharp toenails. Now, Amamma is again into her snipping and stitching of the sari. And the girl is curious to know what she is going to make out of this curtain now. And behind her, there are her siblings, her friends playing. You see, now the sari is become into a baby sling, a snug baby sling, where the baby is sleeping with its finger in its mouth. And the girl is doing some artwork with her paint all over her fingers. And now she is fallen asleep with her baby brother without cleaning her hands and all the mess in her hand. And what happened to the ink pot? It fell down. The whole of the painting has spoiled the baby's snug. Now
Amamma is really thinking, what is she going to do with this baby sling which has got ink all over? Now, Amamma has made tiny little clothes for the dolls and all. It's very cute. She's again snipped and stitched.
It's so nice to
see the girl is sleeping with her doll, with her bedtime doll, which has the dress which is stitched by Amamma from her toned out sari. And if you see this side, the other side, the cat is playing with the soft toy, which again the outer one is made from the sari. If you see here, this is how the story has been weaved into. Initially it was a sari, and then it was made into a curtain, and then it was made into a pillow cover, and then a baby sling, then a soft toy dress, and then finally the sari has been reused many times. Do you all agree that Amamma was creative? I do. This was my way of narrating this wordless picture book. You can narrate in your own way. Go back to the pages and look at it if you can add your own narration. And have fun. Hope you all observed the pages of the book. So as I told you, it's Nivedita Subramaniam's, her special book where she has, the cloth collages which have weaved together in this wordless book. And you can feel that, touch and feel of the sari in this particular book. And basically it's about the sensory memories of her Amamma, her grandmother, for whom upcycling was always as natural as being in a sari. So that's the gist about why she brought out this book.